Welcome to the Residence Life training video. I'm Edgar Gonzalez, your host and resident, and I've been asked by the Residence Life staff to talk to you a little bit what relationships between RAs and residents should be like. I've already spoken to many RAs and residents about their experiences this year, both in the dorms and the apartments. I'd like you to take the next few minutes to listen to what they have to say, and hopefully let it influence you with your relationship with your resident next year.
How do you initiate conversations with residents?
Well, one way I initiate conversations is when we have to put flyers on our doors for programs or events. One thing that I like to do is, instead of just putting the flyer on the door and leaving, is to knock on the resident's door and see if they're home. And if the resident is home, then I'll just, you know, say, how's it going, and talk to them about their classes, see what's going on in their life.
I think you see everyone so much day to day that it's really easy to just strike up a conversation like, hey, where'd you get that necklace, or you fixed your hair different. It's not really hard, except there are those few people that you have to work on, that you really have to search for something deeper. Maybe look up their Facebook and see what they're like, what they like to do. Do they like to play sports? Do they play in the band? And just really feed off those things that you find out about them.
Describe something you did as an RA where you went out of your way to help a resident feel at home or comfortable on campus.
Something I try to do is I like to just mosey on into suites, and if I see a door open, knock on the door and just connect with them, talk to them. Open up some conversation, ask them how they're doing, how their week has been. Another good thing is to ask them what they need prayer for, just to pray with them. Talk about some, I guess, more serious issues and take it one step further than just surface talk.
Well, I really think that one of the biggest gifts that RDs give the RAs is our on-duty nights. They're a really good way to get to know people who are a little bit more reclusive or a little bit quieter, because you get to go to their rooms and you can say hi, and this time you have an excuse. So if they're studying or anything, you can ask them how their classes are going and things. I know one thing that's been a really good tool is that there's been a group hanging out in the lobby every Tuesday and Wednesday night watching American Idol. So if you're on duty those nights, you can go around and to the girls or the guys who kind of stay to themselves, you can ask them if they want to come hang out or take a study break and hang out with y'all.
Have you ever felt awkward when trying to connect with a resident?
Yes.
Could you describe that experience for me?
One time I was going on rounds, and I got to the suite with a lot of international students, and I came in and I sat down and I started talking to them. They were watching the baseball game, so I started watching the baseball game with them, you know, just chilling for a little while. And I was, you know, just making small talk, and I'd ask them a question, and they'd all confer, they'd get together and talk, like they almost huddled. And then after figuring out what I said, then they'd all look at me and answer something, but I never knew what they were saying when they were huddled together, so they could have been like, let's give him a short answer, maybe he'll leave.
Well, there's this one time I had to go and talk to a married couple, because we have married people who live in Husky Village. And I already felt awkward about coming and talking to married people, but then on top of that, they were arguing. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have to go in there and talk to them about trash, and then I also have to talk about the problems that they're having right now. And the husband walks up to the door, and they were actually watching Fight Club.
What kind of first impression did you have of the RAs?
Well, my first impression of my RA, I just thought she was like a big sister to me. She just came in and just said hi to me, and just like kind of rubbed my back a little bit, and just kind of made me feel really welcomed here. And I love that. I live with four other girls and a second brother, and I'm all older than them. And it was just nice to have somebody look after me for once. You know?
Well, I first met my RA when she came to my apartment one afternoon with flyers. And the problem was that I didn't even know she was my RA. I knew my RA's name because I had read it somewhere, but she didn't really introduce herself right away, and I had never gotten a chance to actually see her and know that she was my RA. So I was kind of confused about who she was. And then later I found out, somebody told me, or she told me maybe later, that she was my RA.
Could you describe an experience where an RA made you feel comfortable or uncomfortable?
Well, Chad has always made me feel comfortable, because ever since I moved in, he's been more of a friend than kind of an RA.
You know, I have a pretty good relationship with the RAs. I think they do a good job, especially my RA is Justin, and he's always willing to help.
She made me feel so comfortable whenever I moved in. She told us at our first meeting, we had any questions or concerns, just talk to her about him and she'll see what she could do.
And I remember one time he told me, you know, Pablo, if you need anything at 3-4 in the morning, it doesn't matter, come knock on my door, you know, I will help you, whatever, you know.
He would always ask me how my day was every time he saw me, even though I'd tell him a lot of times it was bad. But he'd always come to my room, kind of like just to say hi, say what's up, just hang out with me.
Whenever I had a problem or a situation, I'd go to her to talk to her about it, and I didn't feel afraid to walk up to her and say, hey, there's something wrong with our toilet.
What kind of things could RAs do that would make you feel welcomed and more comfortable living on campus?
I think that the coffee houses would be really cool, because we did that for the preview weekend, and everyone really enjoyed that, and it was a lot of fun.
The only thing I would say is interaction between the residents and the RAs.
They might be able to hang out with students a little bit more often, maybe a few more programs that are time scheduled better.
I think more whole dorm activities would be cool. I don't know what we could do, but maybe some big game in the courtyard. We have horseshoes put up right now, and I don't know why.
One way that the RAs can improve is the way that they spend their nights on duty.
Also, with activities, they kind of do the same thing off by themselves, but they need to be intermingling and making sure people are having a good time.
If they could just spend a little bit more time with the residents and getting to connect, it would just make the place feel so much more like home.
It is always interesting to see something from somebody else's perspective. When we see things through our eyes and our eyes only, we tend to miss several different ways to perceive what we are seeing. In the same way, relating to your residents can be done in several different fashions. However, your residents may perceive your actions much differently than you. Now that you have seen several different perspectives, I hope that you feel more confident in building relationships with your residents next year. Once again, I am Edgar Gonzalez, and thank you for watching the Residence Life training video.
We've been on the run, driving in the sun, looking out for number one. California, here we come, right back where we started from. Well, hustlers, grab your guns, your shadow.